Greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to Little Force. Today we are going to be covering Fallen Ancients. I was supposed to finish this mission before Operation Scorpion, but it completely slipped my mind. So yeah, let's go ahead and check it out right now. It's basically about rescuing POW abuse held by, you know, the enemy. Map seems straightforward enough. There is surprisingly light activity on the map, but I'm sure once we actually open the map up, it will not be the case. Launch the game. And there seem to be quite a lot of variations in the map. Seem to be a lot of, undulations, deep undulations in the surface, a lot of plateaus for us to overcome. So hopefully the objective will be someplace, you know, which will be easy to access. It seems there aren't many enemies, but I believe I've already said that that might not be the case in the actual mission itself. Most likely these are all snipers and they will be killing us in an instant. Let's check it out though. Mission: rescue the crew of a friendly downed helicopter commander. Helicopter commander. Yeah. Execution: your insertion point is approximately 400 meters south of the last known coordinates of the pilots. Okay, so they have not been captured. I see. The insertion point is considered hot. No shit. I mean, every single insertion point we've had in this mission, as far as the recent campaigns are considered at least, and not just this campaign. I mean, like even I think it started all the way back from Indonesia, but yeah, most of them were pretty intense, to say the least. They were all hot, and I was just wondering, how did somebody manage to insert me at a point like that? Such a hot insertion point is what I never could understand. For the road to the northeast, your pre-programmed GPS coordinates will take you to the foothills towards Objective Gideon. The pilots are pinned down approximately 160 meters north of that position, or rather that point. Once you reach the pilot, guide them to the extraction point. Okay, so it's not a POW rescue mission, it's actually an extraction rescue mission. Like, they're not POWs yet, they're just a crash crew, and we need to extract with them. Hopefully, the enemy will not be getting to them first, or even if they do, they won't be killing them. Which is approximately 325 meters to northeast. If both pilots are killed, this mission will be a failure. So, the loss of one pilot is acceptable? That does not make sense. Expected enemy forces. The airborne combat search and rescue mission coordinator reports that the pilots are currently pinned down by small arms fire. Oh no. The helicopter went down in the area of a fortified forward enemy listening post. That would probably explain the less amount of enemies. Enemy reaction has been swift and multiple patrols are closing on the crash site. There we go. Your insertion point will drop you between two enemy patrols. Expect to be spotted coming in. Oh shit. I mean, that's pretty much what happens in every single one of these missions. Anyway, stealth is a myth in this game. Except for that one mission from Chad. Yeah, it has been a stealth for the most part. Stealth has been a myth for the most part. Allied support Alpha team will land northwest of you. They will proceed northeast approximately 175 meters to the road. Across the road and then proceed approximately 385 meters east, linking up with you at Objective Gideon. They will engage any patrols that they encounter. Charlie team will land east of you, approximately 700 meters from the extraction point. That is quite far. They will head north directly to the extraction point. Once they arrive at the extraction point, they will establish perimeter securing the landing zone. Why don't they just land at the extraction zone itself? Oh wait, hot extraction? I suppose, yeah. But somewhere a little closer to the extraction point if that's their objective, you know. Situation. And air combat operations have increased in tempo, Joint Operation Command's Combat Search and Rescue Coordinator has issued a warning order initiating lifeguard ready teams. Special forces teams from all services have been assigned a duty schedule with a sit ground alert with the search and rescue helicopter crews, ready at 5 minutes notice to respond to any report of a downed aircraft. It's Bravo team's turn in the rotation. I see, so it's like a very frequent occurrence, this downing of helicopters. I do not suppose that is particularly realistic. Then again, I haven't known warfare that well. So, I mean, I would imagine, considering the fact that the Black Hawk down incident in Mogadishu was a huge deal, that it's not as frequent, but who knows, maybe it is. So, you never know. I'm just gonna check out my gear. Since everything is within like a 400 meter range, I think the M4 would work best. And we are being recommended a saw for I don't know what reason. Well, I would love to use the saw. I think I should just switch over to the M4 because I would really appreciate the scope. In addition to the fact that, I don't exactly want to commit friendly fire, and the fact that there aren't as many enemies being displayed on the map. Second change I'm gonna make is I'm gonna choose Spec Ops 45. I don't know why they, you know, push the silenced revolver on you. Not the revolver, it's more of a pistol, but anyway, let's start this mission, check out what it's about. And if we require that extra firepower, we'll just switch over to the saw later. Or maybe we might even have to use the sniper, who knows.
King 6 to all elements, you are clear to move in on the objective.
Everything was going so smooth in the previous run, I almost finished the mission, but somebody got lucky. Which is pretty much the story of this game anyway. Like, everything keeps going smoothly until somebody gets lucky. And I do not mean in the good way, I mean they managed to get a lucky shot on you. And ruin your day for everybody. But yeah, let me just try the thing that I tried previous time.
Bravo, heads up. We have contact to the north. Units are attempting to reinforce.
Roger, King 6. I wonder what King 6 actually is. Is that like Central Command, or is that like another term for... Oh, come on, die. There you guys are. More enemies headed here. And the previous time around, Alpha Team was greatly helping me. And I hope that they continue to do that this time as well. And engaging the enemy, if not taking them out. So. And let me just go ahead and try to take these people out as well. It'll definitely make things easier for a lot of people. Oh, die. Well, I simultaneously like the fact that this game has a...
Bravo, this is Charlie. We'll cover the extraction route.
Bullet drop system. Yeah. I also find it a little annoying at times. Especially at times when I'm trying to make it without dying. Like, without my friends dying. Because speed is essential to this mission. And you need to get to the objective as soon as possible. So, being one of the reasons why I'm taking a rather unconventional approach here. To get to objective killing. I'm just gonna let Alpha Team deal with those people. And it's a really bad thing that you can't bunny hop in this game, otherwise that would have been golden.
Alpha 2 is hit! I repeat, Alpha 2 is hit!
My condolences to Alpha 2 and his family. Yeah, this is like literally the shortest way to the objective, and that is what I'm gonna take. Once we get here, we just need to protect our assets for as long as possible. That guy's dead. Should be more people here, I do believe. I don't know who's shooting at me. I can see you. I don't know where you guys came from, but yeah, I'm gonna keep shooting you guys until you're dead. I'm not gonna let you hurt my friends. How many shots are you going to take to go down? My god. Dry fire, excuse me. You know, given the structure of this mission, I am tempted to use the saw. I think they made like a proper recommendations when they told us to use the saw. And I think I'm missing most of my shots because I'm not aiming properly. And once I start aiming properly, I'll probably be able to hit most of my targets. That is Charlie 1, that is most likely Charlie 2. Yes, there are some enemies right in front of us and we just need to get to them quickly. Good job, guys! You guys got the soldiers. Impressive job, impressive shooting. Now come on, we need to go. I don't know where you guys are, but we need to move now. We need to start moving towards extraction. Come on. Come on. Yeah, there you are. Come on.
Glad to see you guys.
Come on.
This is Dark Horse. We're on the move to the LZ.
And yeah, there's just one enemy in between us and the exfiltration at this point. And I'm just hoping that people from behind do not manage to kill me this time around.
Bravo, King 6. Proceed to extraction point.
I'm just gonna turn on burst fire mode because I would rather have the accuracy.
This is Black Widow. ETA is 3 mics.
That guy's dead, I suppose? Yes, he is. Come on. Let us stay. I suppose the map is clear of hostiles at this point. Like, I cannot see any enemies shooting at me, so I would suppose it is. Come on. Come on, son. Why are you guys stopping there? We'll take care of those hostiles as they keep coming. That is our extraction point. Moving towards extraction. These guys have a habit of sticking exactly to the designated objective route. And it would seem that Charlie and Alpha Team are doing a pretty good job of protecting us during this essential phase, this crucial phase. And yeah, that was a successful mission. Took a few tries, took some doing, but once you think a little strategically about these things, especially once you're actually in the field, things tend to get much easier. If it wasn't for the need for speed in this mission, it could have been much easier, but this wasn't bad either. Not bad at all. Let's go ahead and read the mission debriefing. Thank you, Charlie 1 and 2. My control is Alpha 2. Thank you, Alpha 1. Alpha 2's sacrifice shall not be forgotten. 24 kills. Not that matters, but this is sort of like a blitzkrieg sort of thing. And not bad, not a bad mission, not a bad concept on top of that. Your timely rescue of the downed pilots has been a tremendous morale boost. Since the lifeguard ready teams have been operational, not an air crew has been lost. That is extremely well. That is good news, yeah. That is extremely well. I don't know if anybody even says that. Anyway, our focus is now on eliminating the threat that the enemy's nuclear weapons pose. Human intelligence has revealed the location where a laptop computer is located. A football? It contains the accounting line designators necessary to launch and target those weapons. With their backs to the wall, we can expect them to begin using those weapons in time now. We must neutralize that threat immediately. Roger, and that did not open up any new mission. We only have mission Snowblind and satellite uplink facility. It should help in maybe neutering the power of the football, or rather the nuclear briefcase. For those who haven't watched my playthrough of Splinter Cell, or any playthrough of Splinter Cell, or have played Splinter Cell for that matter. And there's just Whirlwind, which is an enemy outpost. Now, they did say that these two missions are essential, and the choice of which one to accomplish first falls on me. But I don't know if finishing one of these missions will like lock the other, but I suppose that's not how this game works anyway. So this is an outpost destruction mission, Frank Castle. This is a satellite destruction mission. Osiris. I wonder what an Egyptian god has to do with Novaya Zemlya. But anyway, that was it for for Operation Fallen Angels. And the mission was rough. It required the skill and precision of, like, the speed and precision of a highly trained operative. And I'm pretty sure that unless I had like replayed this map for a few times and actually like been playing this game for a few days now, I doubt I would have been able to properly accomplish my objectives here in this mission. So yeah, thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking with me through this mission. And the next time we come around, I think I will target Operation Slowbars. Excuse me. Snowblind first, because it seems a little important-ish. So once we're done with that, then we will target objective Whirlwind. Now, why I think there's a distinction between not distinction, what am I saying? Why I think there is a choice between these two missions and they should probably, you know, like, pull the other mission is primarily because, well, they were talking about the weather setting in and, you know, having to cease operations before that time. But I think we sort of, like, cleared those doubts with Operation Chain Lightning when we... No, not Chain Lightning. I think it was Operation Rapid Strike when we captured that, you know, forward operation base. So, anyway, like, when we come back next time, we'll be targeting Operation Slowbind. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.